I'm Charlie Min for live event news.
Ah, yes! Oh, the lights finally came on, folks. We've been having trouble with the lights all day here in New York, and what a creepy day it's been for me. There's a weird feeling in the air, and it's been such a strange, strange day. Oh, yes, it can get even more strange. I'm talking about a WWF Heart Attack World Tour coming right here, Madison Square Garden, tonight, Manhattan, 8 o'clock, tonight, and like I was saying earlier, what a strange day it's been. I come into work, and there's all these cobwebs on my... We better get into the matches. The Mr. Bob Backlund Challenge. Can anybody break out of the chicken wing? Talk to me, Bob.
You know, I'm a very benevolent, convivial, and gregarious individual. And I'm going to give everybody, all you plebeians, a chance to get in the ring if you think you can get out of the chicken wing. And if you do, I'll retire from the WWF.
Paranoid Bob Backlund just might snap again tonight. Back to the matches we go. We will see Duke the Dumpster Drozdy on one side, the Taxman Erwin R. Seister on the other. Adam Bomb will try to put the Atom Smasher on the Beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow. The Smoking Guns, Barton Billy, will take on Dr. Tom Pritchard and Jimmy Del Rey, the Heavenly Bodies. Doink will have Dink in his corner. Jerry the King Lawler will have Queasy in his corner. Lex Luger, Made in the USA, will face Tatanka. Championship match, Bret the Hitman Hart will defend his gold. Jim the Anvil Neidhart has a tremendous opportunity. And the unbelievable casket match, Undertaker and Yokozuna. The winner has to put the loser in a ringside casket and slam the lid. Tickets will be available at the Madison Square Garden box office and at all Ticketmaster outlets. Charge by phone 212-307-7171. The WWF Heart Attack World Tour in Manhattan tonight.
Welcome back, everyone, to more WWF action. We thank Charlie Min for the live event news. Indeed, a lot of news being made these days.
Orsino.
Aha, guest ring announcer. Go get him, Matt.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by their manager, Captain Lou Albano.
And as a
future. And trainer, Hoffa.
Yeah, in the wonderful world of fast food.
Fast food.
I get a job at McDonald's.
Wow, Howard Pink will move over.
If I could do a little work on Matthew there, look how big his head is.
Bob Stahl and Barry Horowitz.
All right. You know what I thought of Matthew?
What?
I can't tell you, I can't talk and gag at the same time.
Matthew Orsino, ladies and gentlemen, the guest ring announcer. Doing an outstanding job. And Captain Lou Albano doing an outstanding job as well. This is the first time we've seen this particular combination of the head shrinkers. Here on WWF Superstars, when we last saw the head shrinkers, it was Samu Fatu. Now it is Fatu and Sioni.
There's three of them, right?
A little confusing.
Sort of like Cheesy, Queasy, and Sleazy. What do you think?
No, not like, and how did you come up with those names? I mean,
well, I just looked at Queasy, and that's how I felt, so I named him Queasy, and then all you have to do is take one look at Sleazy and know that's what he is, and then if you ever get around him, whoo, just take a whiff of Cheesy. That's how I came up with the names.
Someone at Roquefort, huh?
Well, just smell him if you get close to him.
Well, why would you, I mean... Well, we'll get back to that later on.
What?
Sleazy, Queasy, and Cheesy?
You want me to bring them out here now?
No. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, it's spot two in there, standing side headlock. And coming up, Horowitz is behind spot two. Grabs the forearm to the smaller back. Look at that maneuver.
Whoa! Nicely done.
Uh-oh. However, I think he just raised the air of Fatu.
Pins him over front face lock.
Horowitz drops him down. Fatu right back up. What's going on here?
He's having no effect. But...
Fatu has himself on the back. Just like Barry Horowitz does. And Horowitz
makes the tag. Here comes Mr. Starr now.
Speaking of Halloween, he's a little early. Albano is, isn't he?
Captain Lewis Albano.
Yeah, he's already got that horrible face on.
That's his normal face. Are you insinuating?
That's his real face?
That he's wearing a mask?
I would hope so.
Star to the buckle. And here comes Sioni.
So he can go trick-or-treating as is, huh?
At least he doesn't wear a cape and a ridiculous-looking crown and go knock on the door and ask for trick-or-treats.
McMahon, you're a fine one to look at, talk about how somebody dresses. Your clothes do make a statement, though.
Well, thank you.
That statement is, I have no taste.
Cioni in control. Bob Starr is having his problems, as you suspect anyone would, against the head shrinkers. And, of course, ladies and gentlemen, the head shrinkers are joined by Razor Ramon, whom we saw in action earlier on. The 1-2-3 kid and the British Bulldog as the bad guys. Yes, on the Survivor Series against the Teamsters.
Take a look at this Cioni. You know, he's pretty aggressive, pretty mean looking there.
You might say he's a little more barbaric.
You know why I like that, though?
Right.
Because, what's this guy's name, this red-headed guy here?
Bob Starr.
Reminds me of, he's like a Ronald McDonald look-alike. And I hate clowns.
Uh-huh.
I've never liked clowns. All my life I've hated clowns. When I was a kid, I loved Howdy Doody, but I hated Clarabelle.
And look at this, ladies and gentlemen, from the top of two. But catapult. Cioni, 4-2. Better known as the head shrinkers. And throw Samu in there as well.
Hey, speaking of Howdy Doody.
You're never nice. Matthew Orsino, thank you very much. Guest ring announcer. The head shrinkers hot on the tag team champions trails. And, well, certainly they're not the only ones chasing Shawn Michaels and the 7-foot diesel we mentioned earlier. The bad guy, Razor Ramon, in the 1-2-3 kid against the tag team title holders this Sunday afternoon during the Action Zone. However, in terms of single competition, we have a big announcement coming up shortly concerning the WWF Superstars here next week. Right now, back to the replay, King.
Yeah, take a look at this, McMahon. Horowitz applies the DDT, but Batu is not even fazed.
Unbelievable, patting himself on the back.
Yeah, that was a mistake. Put right to the face of Horowitz. Oh, and then that cocky pat on the back. Now look at this. Off the top rope. He can do it to this guy, but if he tries it to the Teamsters, he'll have to do it to all four of them because the Teamsters, as everybody knows, stick together.
Yes, indeed. And I would suggest to you that Bob Starr's going to be sticking to the mat after we just saw Fatu flying through the air with the greatest of ease.
Speaking of sticking to stuff, what do you think is in Albano's beer?
Let's not get into that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we mentioned earlier on single competition here on the Superstars next week. Here we go!
Cowboys and Indians. It's the oldest kids game around. This one wrestles for good. This one wrestles for greed. And after these two warring factions meet in the ring, no one will remember the Alamo. Billy Gunn battles Tatanka. Next week on WWF Superstars.
Welcome back, everyone, to WWF Action. And there you see them, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, along with his brother-in-law, Owen.
Owen Hart from Rio Nevada.
You know what I love, McMahon? When that music starts playing and all these morons jump to their feet expecting the Hitman to come out.
Well, of course, that was the music that would play when the Old Heart Foundation, if you would come out to the ring, making reference to the WWF champion, Bret Hart, when in fact he did team up with Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
But rightfully so, it now belongs to the man who was the backbone and leader of that team, the Anvil.
Oh, really?
Right.
Jim the Anvil Neidhart going, all right, look at this, going to work on Corey. As he backs to the corner, the official will have his hands full in his match, no doubt about it. Continuing to hammer away. Closed fist. Come on, ref. Get in there. Mike Corey being set up. Out in front now, the big anvil coming up. And Corey.
What about that, McMahon?
All right, that was impressive. I'll grant you that.
Impressive?
Yeah.
Did you see the strength, the power, and the force behind that? Look at this.
Jim the Anvil Neidhart just hammering away on Mike Corey. Jim the Anvil Neidhart, however, ladies and gentlemen, teaming up with the rest of his Teamsters, his brother-in-law, Owen, as well as Triple J, Jeff Jarrett, whom we saw in action earlier on. And they, of course, team up with the tag team title holders. Whether or not they'll be champions for too much longer, a matter of some conjecture. Diesel and Shawn Michaels. You know, that's uncalled for.
What's that?
I mean, you shouldn't be verbally taunting an opponent like this.
Well, you know what he's doing? He's recalling his old football days in the NFL when he played for the Cowboys and the Raiders.
Yeah, right. And I might add, a rather short-lived football career. He couldn't abide by the rules and regulations in football any more than he does in the WWF.
Cross
body block. Oh!
Sort of backfire. Jimmy Anvil Neidhart, a powerhouse, catching Corey in midair, drops him down to the canvas.
That's the way he used to drop quarterbacks.
I think he's been dropped on his head one time too many.
Hey, I'll tell him you said that.
Go ahead, because I think he'd agree.
Look at that.
You mean to tell me this is a normal human being?
It's over!
Yeah.
Here is your winner, Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
It was Jim the Anvil Neidhart who poisoned Owen Hart against his brother Bret. No doubt about it.
Come on.
Owen and Neidhart, ladies and gentlemen, headed to Survivor Series.